Hey there, everybody. It's Pastor Jason. I'm glad you can join me for Daily Devotionals. It's another nighttime edition. We've been doing VBS at our church, and so things have been a little bit later. We're in 2 Corinthians chapter 5 today. We're going to talk more about our earthly bodies and our heavenly bodies and what we are meant to do with our time here on earth. Let me pray and we'll get into it. Father, thank you for your love and your kindness and your generosity towards us. May we seek to please you. Father, we love you. In your name, amen. Verse 1, here we go. For we know that if our temporary earthly dwelling is destroyed, we have a building from God, an eternal dwelling in the heavens, not made with hands. Indeed, we groan in this body, desiring to put on our dwelling from heaven. Since when we are clothed, we will not be found naked. Indeed, we groan while we are in this tent, burdened as we are, because we do not want to be unclothed, but clothed, so that morality may be swallowed up by life. And the one who prepared us for this very purpose is God, who gave us the Spirit as a down payment. So we are always confident and know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord. For we walk by faith, not by sight, and we are confident and satisfied to be out of the body and at home with the Lord. Therefore, whether we are at home or away, we make it our aim to be pleasing to Him. For we must all appear before the tribunal of Christ, so that each may be repaid for what he has done in the body, whether good or worthless. Therefore, because we know the fear of the Lord, we seek to persuade people. We are completely open before God, and I hope we are completely open to your consciences, thank you, as well. We are not commending ourselves to you again, but giving you an opportunity to be proud of us, so that we may have a reply, so that you may have a reply for those who take pride in the outward appearance, rather than in the heart. For if we are out of our minds, it is for God. If we have a sound mind, it is for you. For Christ's love compels us, since we have reached this conclusion. If one died for all, then all died. And if he died for all, so that those who live should no longer live for themselves, but for the one who died for them and was raised. From now on, then, we do not know anyone in a purely human way. Even if we have known Christ in a purely human way, yet now we no longer know him in this way. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things have passed away, and look, new things have come. Everything is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ, and gave us the ministry of reconciliation. That is, in Christ, God was reconciling the world to himself, not counting their trespasses against them, and he has ambassadors for Christ, certain that God is appealing through us. We plead on Christ's behalf. Be reconciled to God. He made the one who did not know sin to be sin for us, so that we might become the righteousness of God in him. Wow, that last paragraph from 16 to 21, so powerful. I would urge you, go back, read through that section again. You know, we're appealing, be reconciled to God. That's why I've been doing this. It's hopefully that you might be reconciled to God. We're trying to make it easy, approachable. We're trying to take the Bible, take it in short little chunks, take it and figure out, what do we learn about the Lord and what do we learn about man? Like, well, we have good capacity and bad capacity. Is there a sin to avoid? Is there a commandment to follow? How do we come away changed? We can answer all these questions here. How are you doing? If you've been watching the entire New Testament, we're getting close to wrapping it up. We should be wrapped up in October. How have you come away changed in our time? How have you become changed in a good way over the past year and a half? It's important for us as Christians to recognize that even now, even today, we are called to be His ambassadors, that we have a ministry of reconciliation, that God is reconciling the whole world through His Son Christ, and we are part of that. That's what we proudly proclaim, because we have this earthly dwelling, this body of ours, that's going to fade away, but we have a new body coming because of our faith in Christ. I hope chapter 5 has been a blessing to you. I would plead for you to go out, be a blessing to someone tomorrow, specifically by encouraging someone to be reconciled to God. And with that, I will see you tomorrow with chapter 6.